In this lecture, we are going to focus upon archetypal criticism with a reference to Northrop Frye. So, before this, we have discussed that what are the things which are called archetypes, because archetypes are those images which are recurrently available, or recurrently can be imagined, or recurrently can be thought, or recurrently can be observed in the human experiences. So, whereas this concept of archetypal criticism or archetypes with reference to Northrop Frye is concerned, he says that all narratives fall into one of four mythos. All narratives mean, narrative means that all those which are parts of literature, drama, novel, short story, poetry, all these, they are another narratives. So he says that they fall into one of the four mythos, and the very first one is a comedy, then is romance, then is tragedy, and then is satire. He says that if you want to understand any piece of literature, first of all you must try to know that whether it is a comedy, it is a romance, it is a tragedy, or a satire or irony, and only then you can be able to understand that piece of literature in a good manner. And we don't need any other thing to know about this piece of literature. We have to keep in mind that these are the genres, these are the four mythos which are used, and we can understand a piece of literature. Then he has tried to elaborate, and he elaborated his theory, and he says that comedy is compared to spring, then romance is compared with summer, tragedy is compared to autumn, and then satire or irony is compared with winter. Now these are the four seasons: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. These are the four seasons. Four seasons mean that these are part of environment, and when these are part of environment, mean that they are part of life, part of universe, part of ecology, part of everything. So when these are joined together, they make a whole time period of life, and we live in those times, we enjoy those times, we enjoy those mythos of seasons. So why he has tried to compare them with these? Because he says that these mythos, they are spring, summer, autumn, winter. They mean the life. Life is in these seasons. Life is related with them. When life is related with them, it means that we can compare them with the genres of literature, and then we can understand a piece of literature. For example, he says that the most important thing is that how these categories, these things are a part of literature, how these are reflected in literature. When you will come to know that how these are reflected in literature, then you will be in the position to understand a piece of literature. This is very important, that human beings project their narrative imagination in two ways: in representation of an ideal world and in representation of the real world. Two types of world. One is the world of this concrete realities of life, and then other is an ideal world that is that world is different from this real world. So human being, their narratives, their thinking pattern, they are going to describe their inner thoughts in two ways: in representation of an ideal world and in representation of the this real world. And whereas this ideal world is concerned, it is the world of innocence, it is world of beauty, and it is fulfillment. And usually this is which is called the ideal world, that is world of imagination, that is utopian world. That world is that something we, because when we are in this life, we have to face concrete realities of life. We have tension, we have frustration, we have anxieties, we have disturbances, and there are countless disturbances. And when we are facing them, we have to move towards a real world, towards from the real world to the ideal world. Why? Because we want to get rid of these things, and then we idealize certain things, that these things must be changed like that way, and only then life will be beautiful. So ideal world is the world of innocence, it's world of beauty, it is world of fulfillment, it is world of goodness, it is world of happiness. So false calls it the mythos of summer. Fall says that this is the mythos of summer, and this mythos of summer is associated with what is called romance. Romance, this genre of literature is called romance, and it is associated with the mythos of summer. What is romance? Romance is a world of adventures. Successful quest is part of romances. Stories of bravery are here, and then there is virtuous heroes, beautiful maidens, overcome bad circumstances, and these good people, heroes and heroines, they not only overcome bad circumstances, rather they overcome bad people, bad situations, ill situation, everything that is evil that is overcome by them. So this genre, which is called romance, it is related with, associated with the mythos of summer. So this is the concept, this is the thing which Nathan Fry wants to say. And then the second thing is the representation of the real world. Real world, it is a world of experiences, world of concrete realities of life. This is the world of tensions, world of frustrations, world of problems. This is the real world. And what is here? Uncertainty is here. Failure is here. Everything bad is here. Everything ill is here. And he, Rotherham Fry, calls it the mythos of winter and associates it with stir and irony. Whereas this stir is concerned, stir means that you are going to ridicule a thing, ridicule what? Ridicule an idea, ridicule an ideology, ridicule a religious system, ridicule a political system, ridicule an economic system, ridicule culture, ridicule policies, ridicule persons, their situations. You are going to ridicule them, and in a sarcastic manner you are going to make fun of them, so that perhaps they may change themselves after knowing that we are going to sterilize, because the purpose of stir is reformation. They want all those who are the right stirs, actually their purpose is to change the thinking patterns of people. So he says that it is the mythos of winter associated with the spring, stir and irony. And whereas irony is concerned, irony means that there is a difference between apparent situation and then real situations. And in this world where there is stir and irony, heroes are defeated and they try to be heroic, but they fail, and they dream of happiness but cannot happiness. It means that they try to get something beautiful, they try to overcome problems, they try to be happy, they try to get solace, they try to get relaxation, they try to get rid of the problems of life and tensions of life, but they cannot get it. So this is a thing which is related with stir and irony. And he says that this is mythos of winter. So whereas this mythos of summer is concerned, so it is related with romance. And then there is mythos of this winter is concerned, it is related with stir. Now the next two we are going to discuss are, number one is tragedy, and then there is comedy. Now whereas this thinking pattern or representation of this life or representation of your narrative is concerned, writers or persons or their things move from the ideal world to the real world and real world to the ideal world. And this movement from one world to the other, from for example from ideal to the real world and real world to the ideal world, what will be the result of this movement? The result will be that we will come to know that it is a tragedy, and then it can be a comedy. So the rest two mythos involve a movement from one of these world to the others. Whereas this tragedy is concerned, this is related with the movement from ideal ideal to the real world. Movement of a character from the ideal world to the real world is called mythos of winter, and it is also called mythos of autumn, and it is related with the movement from summer to winter. When it is movement from summer to winter, it means that it is also a movement from ideal to the real world. In ideal world means that in ideal world the hero is very happy, he is not going to have any problem, there is happiness everywhere, there is goodness everywhere, he is living a peaceful life. Then a time comes when he starts facing problems, and his ideal world is crashed, and the result is that he has to move towards the real world. And what happened there? That there is he falls from a high position, his position is no more the same, and he moves from position A to position B, and where he either dies or I have to face quite changed set of circumstances. And because this is tragedy, so those changed set of circumstances are not positive, they are always negative, they are catastrophic in nature, they are disturbing in nature, they are harming the characters. So tragedy is a movement from ideal world to the real world and from summer to the winter. And so Fry calls that it is a mythos of autumn, and hero falls from the ideal world to the real world. So this is called tragedy. And then the next is comedy. So comedy is a movement from the real world to the ideal world. Real world, when we move from the ideal world to the real world, that's tragedy. And when we move from the real world to the ideal world, and that is called comedy. And here we are going to move from experience to innocence, from Mumtaz of winter to the Mumtaz of summer, and that's why comedy is called a Mumtaz of spring. And here what happens, hero overcomes the hurdles of life, hero tries to end disturbances, and in the end he succeeds in getting happiness. Now, whereas this concept of archetypes is concerned, so archetypes means form. So he has tried to tell us that there are four main types of genres of literature. One is comedy, romance, tragedy and satire. The very first thing, a person who is going to have the meanings of a piece of literature, he must try to understand that what is the structure of this piece of literature, whether it falls under the heading of comedy or it falls under the heading of romance or it falls under the heading of tragedy and satire or tragedy or satire. So when you have come to know that it is one of all these, then you can understand that what is actually happening, what is the reference of these, or what is the relation of these things with these seasons, which are called the Mumtaz of spring, Mumtaz of summer, Mumtaz of autumn, Mumtaz of winter. So what is the relationship between them, and these which are the Mumtaz of, and what happens under these circumstances, and then you can understand the real meanings of a piece of literature. Because archetypes are recurring images, recurring ideas, recurring motifs which are repeated with the passage of time. It means that from primordial time, from time immemorial, people, because mind, it is usually said that mind, people think in the same way, act in the same way, behave in the same way, and their nature is the same, they are nurtured in the same way, because all the people live in societies, all the people have their cultures, all the people go through different type of hurdles of life in order to live life. They are educated in academic and through other sources. It means that human beings, there are certain so many things which are common among all of them. When those things are common among all of them, it means that we can understand a piece of literature by going through a piece of literature, that these things are part of our life. So archetypes, and we also know that spring season, we are aware of it, then there is summer, then there is autumn, then is winter. So we are aware of it. It means that these are also the things which are called archetypes, and when we are aware of them, then we can understand by comparing them with comedy, romance, tragedy and satire. And then we can come to know that, because when we are clear about this, that in a tragedy always something wrong happens, there is catastrophic, some disturbing happens, so then we can understand a piece of literature. In comedy, there is happiness, there happiness, happy ending is there. A character moves and tries to get happiness, and he succeeds, and then we can understand. And then where a star is concerned, we can come to know that a writer, dramatist, novelist, writer, poetess, or a poet, he is trying to sterilize the society. Why he sterilizes society? Because its actual purpose is to mold the way of thinking of the people, to mold the ways of living of the people, so that may come out, may show out a beautiful society, and then you can understand. Then there is romance is concerned. So romance is a thing that is perhaps related with something beautiful. Adventurous stories are there, and then they overcome over bad circumstances, and there are beautiful maidens, and they are virtuous heroes. It means that with romance there is something goodness is associated. So whereas this archetypal is concerned, it means that we don't need any other thing to understand a piece of literature. We just need to know these archetypes, and then we can understand a piece of literature in an authentic way.